Hi, I'm Gaylerd. Hey, you know, I've been getting a lot of emails recently from folks asking me what level of guitar player do they need to be in order to sign up for the new Big Dawg guitar series. But I thought probably the best thing to do would just be let you see for yourself. So I put a short preview together to give you an idea of what you can expect from the series. So take a minute and watch it for yourself. Then leave me a comment and let me know what you think. And I'll see you in the videos. I realize that the main reason that we learn to play acoustic guitar is to be able to play songs, because playing songs on a guitar in front of an audience is probably one of the most coolest and fun things that you can do. And if you're like just about every other guitar player, you're gonna wanna be able to play those songs better than the other guys. But the problem is, a lot of good folks get so eager about learning how to play that they get caught up watching a few videos on YouTube on how to play a few of the basic chords, but they never really learn much past that. Then they get stuck in a rut and never really learn how to change between those chords smoothly and still keep those chords sounding crisp. Big Dawg guitar is all about adding those little riffs and fills to your chords so it almost sounds as if two guitars are playing at once. And you've got to be able to change those chords quickly and still make them sound nice.
So let me give you
7 basic fundamentals that'll help you play chords crisp, clean, and smooth. Now look, even if you think you already find it, I'm putting just enough pressure to get a nice, clean sound. Okay, I don't want to squeeze it. If I try and choke that fret, we're going to play it two ways. The first time, we're going to pick your fingers up off those chords, okay? And you're going to use your middle finger to drive these notes. And just your middle finger on the third and the fourth string.
You're taking
and then you
pinky.
Do that, and you're picking up that third fret on that fifth string. Okay, walking down with the middle finger, and that's open. Take that pinky again and grab that third fret on that sixth string, and then back to an A minor chord. So it's okay, let's try it one more time. You ready? Count off 1, 2, 3, 4. Do it with the A minor, do a riff to get down to the E minor, and then do the other riff to get back to the A minor, okay? So here's what we'll do. We'll use that riff to get down to the E minor. All right, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. 3. Here we go. Three, now. Let's do it again. That's 3, here we go. 2, 3, here we go.